everyone, Squatcher Players here, and welcome back to another video. Today, guys, I'm going to be teaching you how to live stream on YouTube with OBS. Follow these steps, and you'll be live streaming in no time. Step 1, go over to your Chrome and type in obsproject.com. Then, once you've done that, you come over to this screen, select your operating system, and click download. Once this is open, you'll see a little scene over here, and nothing at all. So step 1, I'm going to teach you how to fix all your settings, because that's like the most simple thing. You want to come into here, and if you have a microphone, we're going to go through that first. So first, you want to probably turn on your desktop audio and select the device that you're using. For me, it's headphone, HyperX Virtual Surround Sound. Step 2, you want to come down to your mic auxiliary audio. Select your microphone. Once you've done that, you're done with audio. Viewers will now hear you. Now down here in the audio mixer, you can change volume. So my voice is pretty loud right now, so I'm going to turn that down to like green area and turn that down to like that. You can mess around with this and test record, etc. to see how your audio records. Also, how to record. You come over to this button, you click start recording. Or click start streaming. This tutorial is about streaming, so we're going to be teaching you how to stream. Step 2. Creating scenes. You can easily make a scene by just clicking this plus button, which makes multiple scenes. You can right click a scene and click rename to rename the scene. I'm going to call this starting soon. Then, once you've selected the scene that you would like, you come over to the sources tab and you can click plus. You have a ton of these options, and the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to use TextGDI. Then we can type in a name. So we're just going to call this Starting Soon TXT. You can name this whatever you want. Once you have this, we're going to select the font, and you can select any font you want. I'm just going to use Luckiest Guy because that's the best font. Then you can click where it says text here, and you can type in any text. So click, for example, I can type in starting soon. And then boom. You click OK, and you have this starting soon. Now, if you want to center anything, you can right-click it, come down to transform, and then click center on the screen. Or you can click center vertically, which is the up and down. Or you can click center horizontally, which is the left and right. I'm going to center on screen so it looks nice like that. Step 2, importing images. You can click the plus button and you can go to an image and you can click image. Once you've done that, name it whatever you want and then come here. Once you're here, you can click browse and image files and select an image. For me, I'm just going to select my most recent thumbnail, which was an MM2 Godly stream. Click OK, and once you've done that, you have an image. Now you'll see that it's overlapping the text, so it's kind of useless. So what you want to do is you want to come down to the sources and grab the image and drag it below the starting soon until you see that white line below it. Once you've done that, the starting soon will show up on top of the image. You can resize an image by dragging on any of the vertices. These little boxes will resize the image. You can also crop an image by holding Alt and dragging. This will trim down the image. So say we just want to get the scorcher, we can drag all the sides in until we get the little scorcher. To full screen an image easily, you can right click the image, go to transform, and then go down to fit to screen, or press Ctrl F. Now we have a big scorcher and a starting soon. Now this doesn't look too great, but I'll leave it up to you guys to customize your streams. I'm just going to quickly make this text have a nice little border, so you can come over to your text right here. You can scroll down to where you see outline. Check that box. Then set a size. For me, I'm going to do 20, which is the maximum size. Now click select color and select any color you want. I'm going to use black because it's a very good contrast. Click OK and you are done. I'm just going to move my text around, just try and make this look OK. And yeah. This is my starting soon screen. You could do any animations, anything. You can just click plus and you can go through all these sources, which I'm not going to go through all today, but there is a lot here. Next, we're going to go to scene 2 that we created earlier. And we're going to name this game. Once we have the scene named, we're going to click plus in sources and we're going to add a game capture. This will allow you to stream any game you want. For this, I'm going to set it to capture any full screen application, but you can select it to capture a specific window, capture foreground with hotkey, or yeah, those three options. I like capture any full screen window because it works the best. Next, you want to come down and click OK. Once you have this here, open any game and put it in full screen by pressing F11. I'm going to demonstrate this with Roblox Murder Mystery 2. I've opened the game up and now I click F11 on my keyboard. Once I've done that, my game is full screened and you can play it like normal. Next thing you want to do is head back to your OBS. On Windows, you can press Alt-Tab. On Mac, you can press Command-Tab. I'm pretty sure. Don't quote me on that. And then you can get all these big selection things here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select my OBS. I have another OBS open because I'm recording this video. So come to this OBS and you can see that my game is here now. So now you can basically come down to settings, go to stream, and enter in anything you want. First, you want to select YouTube, RTMPS. Then click server, primary, and just server, which this should be by default, but if it's not, then select it all. Next, you want to come over here to YouTube, you want to click plus, and you want to click go live. Once this is loaded up, you can click schedule stream and click create new. Now that you have this window open, you can type in any title you want. So I'm going to type in memes. You can type in any description you want. So I can just put in here, I can put E or something. Then you can come down here to where your game selection is. You can type in any game you want. So I'm going to be doing Roblox. Then you can upload a thumbnail or leave this blank for it to do your YouTube banner. For mine, I'm going to click upload thumbnail. I'm going to select my thumbnail. I'm going to click upload. Next, I'm going to scroll down here and select if this video is made for kids or not made for kids. I recommend setting your video to not made for kids or people will not be able to comment and your video will not get notifications. Then come down here to select your stream language, caption certificate, and any other information you want down here. Next, click next. If you are monetized on YouTube, you can come over here and click monetization and turn it on. Or off. Next, you'll be on customization. You can customize your stream over here. You'll see live chat replay, participant modes, and message delay, aka slow mode. You can turn this on if you want viewers to send messages in slow intervals rather than spamming. Then click next. Once you're here, you can select public and select the stream time. Then click done. Once you have done that, you'll see this live stream. Firstly, I recommend setting your stream latency to ultra low latency if you want to talk to viewers in real time with no delay. Then you can come over to where it says stream key, paste an encoder right here on the left. Click copy. Once you've copied that, head back over to your OBS. Once you're in OBS, grab your stream key and paste it in. Then click apply and OK. Once you've done that, you can click start streaming and you'll go live to your stream. Hope you guys enjoyed today's tutorial and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.